Hi everyone, I'm Leo and welcome back to our App Inventor tutorials. So today we are going to create a factorial calculator apps. So what is a factorial? We go to the wiki page. A factorial is simply we have an integer and we just multiply all other integers smaller than it. So for example, the factorial of 5 is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is 120. So this is what we are going to do today. For the designer view, it's very simple. We basically need three components: a test bot input, a button for us to interact, and also a label to display our results. So I have already set up these components, so let's move to the blocks view. First we need a global variable, we name it result, and this variable is going to store our calculation results. So we set it to 0 or just 1, and we need to click the button to interact. So when we click our calculation button, we need to do the calculation. And here, if you look at the factorial calculation part, it's a loop. So from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times for factorial 5, so we need a for loop. And instead of calculating it from the number itself, calculate to descending order, we're using ascending order because it's more convenient and easy to use in App Inventor, the for loop. So instead of calculating from 5, we are calculating from 1. So we remove the 5 here, and remember we use the test bot input, so we should find our input test here. So it is going to loop for the number we input. So after it, we need to multiply the things together, and we need to set our variable to that number. So our variable is a global variable, so every time we change it, the global one will also change for the display. So here we get our original result and we multiply it with the number in the loop. So we just simply get this number, and after it we need to display it. So we go to our result label and we set the test to our results. Okay, so I think this is it. So let's check if it works. Here I'm open our emulator. Okay, and let's type 5 and see if the result is 120. Okay, so 1 factorial should be 1. Well, something's wrong, and I know why, because, well, remember every time we click the button, we didn't reset our result. So we need to reset our result to 1 to make sure that every time we click the button, we do not multiply the things again. So we reset it to 1. And let's try again. Okay. Okay, and 2 factorial should be 2, 3 should be 6, 4 should be 6 times 4 is 24. And this is our factorial calculator for this week's lesson. And in next week, I will introduce functions and procedures in App Inventor. So see you guys next week.